tuning in one more time to Resurrecting Your Spirit Ministry. My name is Pastor The Past, and today we're going to have a continuation of the book of Revelation. Last week he was teaching from the book of Revelation, chapter 2. And today we're going to continue. We're going to start off with a prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for your blessings. I thank you, Lord, for all of the anointing that you have poured out. I thank you for a wonderful last week when I was senior pastor Gavin, and for all the deliverance and the word of God that you brought to us during the week of revival. We thank you for those that you touched. We thank you for those who were delivered. And now as they're being delivered, they are coming in every day for counseling, because those demons have been cast out. So now we are depositing the word of God and the word of truth. I'm bringing them to the word of truth and depositing and filling them up with the word of God. We thank you, Lord, for the love that you have placed in our hearts, which is your love, which is your first love. And we thank you. And now we're going to continue today in verse 10 of chapter 2 of the book of Revelation, the letter to the seven churches. These seven churches mean the character of every Christian has to line up with the word of God. This is a time of repentance. This is a time to come back and to come back to your first love. And we read, fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that you may be tried, and you shall have tribulation 10 days. Be not faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. He that had an ear, let him hear that what the Spirit has to say to the churches. And he that overcometh shall not be hurt of the second death. And to the angel of the church of Pergamos write, these things saith he which hath a sharp sword with two edges. I know thy works, and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is. Thou holdest fast my name, and hast not denied my faith, even those days when Antipas, my faithful martyr, who was slain among you, where Satan dwells. But I have two things against thee, because thou hast dear them that hold fast the doctrine of Balaam, which is the doctrine of Balaam. It is the doctrine of the Illuminati. It is the doctrine of the Jews and the Columbos. It is a false doctrine. It is a doctrine of satanic movement that has been happening from the ages of the ages. And it's been happening in this country, in all the countries. And that false doctrine, and that doctrine is wrapped up in rapture. Because a young girl, a 14-year-old girl called Margaret McDonald, her parents was illuminated. She was one of the bloodline of Cain from the McDonald family. 13 families of the bloodline of Cain. The doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balaam to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed unto idols, and to commit fornication. So has those also them that hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans. Nicolai. You have the Greeks. Greece is Nicolai. Romanova. Which thing I hate. Repent, or else I will come unto thee quickly. And I will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh,
will I give to eat of the hidden manna, and I will give him a white stone, and in the stone a new name written, which no man knoweth, saving he that receiveth it. And it says here, this is the characteristic of the church of today. The letter to the seven churches, the spiritual churches, and the physical churches. Hear what the Lord is saying to you. Repent. Repent from your spiritual prostitution. Repent. Repent from making blood covenants and spiritual covenants with your lodges. Repent. Repent from doing animal sacrifice and blood sacrifice all to idols. Repent from recruiting those into witchcraft. The churches need to repent. This is what God says that is happening in the churches. I didn't make it up. I'm just a servant of the Lord. I'm just a woman who studied the Word of God, who studied biblical history, who go back even into history and research the origins of these practices that they practice in the church today. Lift up your right hand, turn to the east. Lift up your right hand, turn to the west. Lift up your right hand, turn to the north. Lift up your right hand and turn to the south. Demonistic, ritualistic, demonic worship. That is what it is. Illuminated. You stunners, these first stars. This doctrine that they tell you to do on Sunday and doing Bible class in your churches, it is a satanic ritual. Repent! Repent! Let we that have ears to hear. Hear what the Lord, what the Spirit is saying to the churches. And to the angel of the church in Thyatira write these things. Saith the Son of God, who hath his eyes like unto a flame of fire, and his feet like fine brass. I know thy works, and charity. Charity means love. And service means servant. And faith, and thy patience, and thy works. And the last to be more than the first. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication, to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And that's what we see in today. We find a spiritual prostitution in the church today. We find that you are turned away from the true teaching and the true worship of our Father, and that you have ceased to do your daily sacrifice unto the Lord, and that you are following a false doctrine, a Jezebel doctrine, a doctrine of devils and demons, a spiritual prostitution, a spiritual covenant, outside of the realm of the true worship of God. And what is God saying today? With seducing spirits, the seducing spirits that you have in their books that they print out. They print out all these books about telling you how you can overcome through the battle of the mind, and all this control and the blueprint that they put in that book is to program you to receive the mark of the beast. You're receiving the mark of the beast. You're being seduced with philosophy, sociology, psychology, satanic worship, and you don't even know, because